Hello and welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Aileen Senpai. I'm a streamer on Twitch, an amateur singer, and a lover of all kinds of music. Now, I recently went down the Tool rabbit hole, and we ended up stumbling upon A Perfect Circle together, and I last dived into Judith. It very much felt like Maynard was in the anger stage of his, stages of grief, and, the frustration was very much apparent. I am fully aware that he does not hate his mother, and this was just his anger towards, religion, the church, and their treatment towards her, and, just wanting her to be better and be present for herself and not for her faith. And I was just, completely blown away. That was just such an emotional video, not just, the lyrics, but vocally and everything else. All the members in A Perfect Circle put on such an incredible performance that just, made that delivery of the song just so, so powerful. And I'm very, very excited to go back into some Tool today. We're going to be doing a double feature. Today we're listening to Wings for Marie and 10,000 Days. I did read up a little bit about some information on these couple of songs, and I did know that 10,000 Days is actually the amount of days that, his mother was, paralyzed from her stroke. So about 27 years. And just knowing the meaning of the song names is already a little chilling. And I did hear from some members from Tool Army that told me that this is more of the acceptance stage of his grief. And I'm very much interested to see the transformation from anger to acceptance in Maynard's vocals and lyrics. But very nervous, excited. I feel like this is going to be quite the emotional roller coaster, but we're in this together, and I'm really excited to dive in further into their catalog and just get inside of his heart and mind. But before I press play on these videos, if you enjoy what you see here, please be sure to give these videos a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another video ever again. We're going to start off first with Wings for Marie, and then we're going to do 10,000 Days right after. But yeah, without further ado, let's get started with these videos. It's kind of like a wings, like a flutter of wings. Thank you. I'm gonna pause right there. That last line cut a little bit deep. What have I done to be worthy? I did see the lyrics beforehand, and I did notice a bit more of a somber tone in his voice. Definitely a lot lower, and almost like a lot sadder. Like his voice sounds sadder. Like he's kind of like whispering through this. Like it's kind of hard to get through these words. Obviously, the song is about his mother, so it must not be easy. You know, just belt this out, especially if you're in an acceptance, you know, stage in your, you know, stages of grief. When you're in anger, you feel like screaming and belting and, you know, adding a bunch of power. But when you're accepting what has happened and you're accepting the loss and allowing yourself to feel all of those emotions in a healthy manner, you start to say things a lot more. It tends to be a lot more somber when you recollect your thoughts and regurgitate these lyrics. Especially when you know the meaning behind them, and they are very, very painful for you to say out loud. And I commend him for, you know, pushing through that and writing this song. It must have been incredibly difficult. You know, writing songs about people we love and lost is never easy, but it is, you know, a form of therapy. It is like a way of, you know, putting all of your thoughts and feelings out onto paper and out into the world, and like you can kind of like breathe a little bit easier. It doesn't make the pain go away, but it makes it a little bit easier and a little bit less lonely. And it also helps other people who have loved and lost, whether it be mothers, you know, partners, whoever it is that they've, you know, gone through similar pain as Maynard. They can hear this and also find solace and therapy in it as well. But his voice just sounds so, so sad. And it makes you feel really sad as well. And, you know, the music in the background is so beautiful. The instrumentals, it just adds so much, you know, pain. Even though it sounds so nice, it sounds painful, and it's very well done. And I commend him for, you know, pushing through and putting this all out for everybody to enjoy and appreciate and respect. And I am very much enjoying it, but I feel really, really just low, very, very somber at the moment. But I'm gonna continue with the video because I feel like we have a lot to unlock here, and I feel like this is not even the beginning of it, so let's get started. Bass. That last line cuts so deep. just it's time for us to let you go. I did want to go back and go into the lyrics just a bit because there was this one line that just completely shattered me because you can tell that he finally came to terms with the acceptance. And you know, he was so angry with her and Judith. He was so angry at the church for turning their back on her and blaming her, making her feel like, you know, what happened to her or her paralyzation, her stroke, all of that was her fault because, you know, maybe she did something to deserve it, which is just completely absurd. And she had dedicated to her life to her faith, and to be betrayed like that by, you know, the same faith that she loved so much was, you know, just so frustrating for him. So this last line, I'm going to, you know, read it. She never told a lie. Well, might have told a lie, but never lived one. Didn't have a life, didn't have a life, but surely saved one. And it's just so sad to hear that. You know, she never told a lie. Well, maybe told a lie, but she never lived a lie. She, you know, was never lying, like how the faith betrayed her, how they were basically liars. They did not commit to their own faith and the stuff that they were preaching. They did not practice what they preached. They turned their backs on her when she needed them most. And, you know, she didn't have a life, didn't have a life. It was all dedicated to them. But she surely saved one. And that was, you know, when I felt so chilled, just knowing that he, Maynard finally came to that, you know, acceptance in the end. And that was just so powerful to hear. And I loved how calm and quiet he was throughout the entire song. It, you know, wasn't like he was belting. It was just, again, like so somber. Like this was just his way of, you know, saying his final goodbyes and, you know, saying he accepts what happened and he still loves her for everything despite all the frustration he felt in Judith. I'm so nervous for part two now. I feel like the lyrics in this were just so strong and powerful, and I don't even know if I'm emotionally ready, but we're gonna get there. So without further ado, let's get started with part two, Wings of Marie. We're gonna be doing 10,000 Days. Pretty killer bass line.
Thank you.
gonna pause just for a second. I love him calling out, you know, the congregation, just a bunch of, you know, hypocrites, because now after everything they are trying to spew these sympathies and act like they care when, you know, they didn't care when you know, Judith Marie needed them the most. So it doesn't sound as angry as Judith, in Judith by a Perfect Circle. It sounds a little bit more like he's accepted that that's just how it is. It is what it is. Unfortunately, they're all hypocrites. But he's not, you know, saying obscenities toward their faith or anything like he did in Judith. It is he's more of accepting that he can't change them, and whatever happened. I also really like the touches, how, you know, there's a thunderstorm in the background. I don't know if it's going to be throughout the entire song, but what I hear from thunderstorms is it's like there's always like a nice rainbow over the thunderstorm. And, you know, in the meantime, the rain is just crashing down on you. It's loud and, you know, it's scary. It could be very destructive. But after it clears, you know, everything comes out, you know, better, nicer. So maybe that's just alluding to the fact that the feelings he had during this moment, now he's like calling out the congregation and all of that and accepting the loss of his mother. And maybe that was everything that was raining down on him. And I feel like this collection is maybe Sun is going to come out after all of this. I'm not sure. I may be overthinking everything, but for some reason, every time I hear thunder and or see it in like a movie or a song or, you know, whatever it is, you can always, you know, it feels scary. But afterwards, there's just so much beauty outside of it because you kind of overcame that, you know, very stressful storm, and you overcame the storm and, you know, wrote it out. But I'm feeling so much. And it's so funny because I feel so much just by Maynard, you know, singing so calmly. Even in Judith, I felt a lot of emotions, him belting, but here he's being so calm and, you know, it's just so much beautiful instrumentals in the background. But at the same time, I still feel really sad for some reason. Like he has a way of evoking those, you know, feelings in your heart, and you can become empathetic with him for, you know, 11 minutes, and you feel all the things he's feeling as well. Like he's so transparent with, you know, himself and his emotions and how he feels. And he just is, his delivery, his songwriting is just impeccable. It is honestly the best songwriting I've ever seen. It really makes you stop and think for a second and fully appreciate what's going on. And you just become empathetic with him. And it's such a beautiful thing. Beautiful and scary, but it's nonetheless a very beautiful thing. But let's continue with the song because we still have quite a bit left and I'm very nervous, but let's get started with this. I think it's just in the fire. 10,000 days in the fire, and now you're going home. You know, 10,000 days that she had to deal with this and be in this condition 27 years, and now she's going home. She has her wings, and that was really sad. Ooh, that was really sad, especially the way he sang that. That was just so just beautiful and sad, beautifully sad. I felt a lot all at once. I want to hear that again, so I'm gonna go back. But wow, that was just very, 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 very moving. To pause. That was making me really, 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 really emotional. It sounds stupid to say, but the way that the guitar and the bass and the drums, everything coming together, it felt like they were acapella-ing a cry, like an agonizing cry. I know that sounds really stupid, but if you think about it, like the way it started like to build up. And he kind of came out of that in his vocals, kind of came out when he was like, give me my, give me my. I felt like they were crying with him. I know that sounds really weird to explain, but it honestly felt like it was done in a way that you can just kind of feel all the pain in Maynard's, you know, voice in the lyrics, and they're kind of like being sad with him. They played it in such a way that you just felt like everyone collectively as a band in that moment was just trying to showcase just how much pain and how painful it is for him to be talking about this subject, about his mother. And I am just, it's so weird because the instrumentals made me well up. I got teary just listening to the instrumentals. Even before his, you know, voice came out, I started feeling, you know, my chest get really heavy, and I felt like I had to focus on my breathing, and I just felt so much just because of that. And wow, I don't ever think an instrument has ever made me cry or want to cry before, but this is a first for sure. And yeah, wow. It's a lot. I'm feeling a lot. I'm feeling quite a bit right now, but let me take a nice little exhale before I carry on with the rest of this, because I feel like I need an inhaler. I should have got a box of tissues before this, but I think I'm ready, so let's continue. The sound of the wings is back. Oh my god. That was a lot. I like how it started in Wings for Marie Part 1 with the wings, and then it ends with the wings. Like she's... it sounds so... oh my god, I can't believe I'm like... I can't even keep it together. It's like the beginning and the end, especially after hearing Judith, after listening to Judith, I felt all of the anger, all of the frustration, and to see his, come full circle and come into acceptance is so beautiful, but so sad. And I can't even put anything into words, but that was so beautifully done. Ending with the wings, like she's finally, free. He himself is also finally free. She's free from the 10,000 days that she was, confined to her wheelchair. And he is free from all of the anger and resentment that he felt. So they're both free from, the chains that they were placed. And I was not expecting to feel all of that at the end there. I knew I was going to get emotional, but I was really not expecting to feel just like it felt like someone like ripped my heart out. But at the same time, I felt at peace because it also felt like he was at peace, and I'm just so blown away by them. Songwriting is just incredibly well done. The bass was so beautiful. I loved the touch with a thunderstorm, and again, like it was very, very apparent in the beginning, and then towards the end, we got the noise of the angel wings, like if the skies cleared, and Judith Marie was able to be up there at the gates. And again, I think maybe it was to show that something good always passes after you wait out the storm. It was a lot, weighing down on him when there was thunder in the background. That's when he was talking about hypocrisy and how the congregation was giving false sympathies and caring when they were not there for her in her life, but now they care once she's gone. And at the end, it was more of the acceptance and her getting her wings and being able to have her life back, her body back, because she was so confined to her illness for 10,000 days, which is it's just it all came full circle, and it's just incredible. It's just so incredibly done, and I feel so much. I feel so much in this moment. I feel so sad. I feel at peace. I feel happy. I just feel everything all at once, and that's something that a lot of bands have never been able to do for me, and it's just something so special about Tool. They have such an incredible way of writing songs, and Maynard is just a lyrical genius. Beautiful voice. Even in Wings for Marie, it was a lot more softer and somber. And then towards, the end of 10,000 Days, you got that, a more power kick in, and his vocals really, really shone through, and it was so beautiful to listen to them back to back. I got such an incredible experience from both of them, and I'm just so grateful for y'all showing me Tool, telling me to listen to them, telling me to listen to these together, because this was just everything I could have, ever asked for and more. And I'm just so moved by Tool time and time again, and I cannot wait to continue to be moved by Tool. So huge thank you to Tool Army recommending me this. If you enjoyed what you saw here, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you never miss another video ever again. Let me know in the comments what you thought. How did this make you feel the first time you heard it? And I can't wait to go further into their catalog. If you would like to talk Tool or talk music in general, I do stream on Twitch every Monday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. I also have a lovely Discord community. Y'all are more than welcome to join. I'm definitely gonna give this another listen, and I think I'm just gonna listen to this with my eyes closed and just feel let all these feelings wash over me. But thank you again. Much love and support. I'll be back very soon. I'll be back tomorrow with some more music. And until next time, I love you so much. Take care of yourself, and bye.